morning. What is your full name?
My full name is Rasti Huram, but you can just call me Rasti.
Where are you from?
I am from Pakistan, and my city name is Wazirabad, which is situated near the bank of Chenab River, and it is famous for its cutlery products.
Okay. Do you work or study?
I am a working lady. I run a private school of middle standard, and I work as a vice principal there.
All right. Where do you live now?
And I I have married in the same city, so my previous city was also Wazirabad, and now I also live in the same city, Wazirabad.
Okay. Do you live in a house or flat?
I live in a house that is very big, and there is a big courtyard in my house, which is my favorite place of my home because it is full of greenery, full of flower and plants.
All right. Can you tell me about your hometown?
My hometown is very famous place in Pakistan. Actually, it is a junction between the three or four cities. It links the four cities together. And it is also famous for its cutlery product all over the world.
All right. What languages do you speak?
I can speak English, Urdu, and Punjabi fluently. Although English is not my mother language, but as we have had read it since our childhood, so we can speak it easily.
Okay. Would you like to learn another language?
Yes, I like to learn Chinese language because you know China is becoming popular day by day. Because of its economic position. So I think in the future, Chinese language will be popular in the world and it will be a gateway of success for everyone.
Okay. Okay, let's talk about your voice. Do you think your voice changed since you were a child?
Yes, I think it's the phenomena which everybody faced when he or she grew up. After his teenage, his voice changed frequent as time passes, and the voice become mature and mature.
Okay. Do you have a voice similar to someone in your family?
Please repeat the question.
Do you have a voice similar to someone in your family?
Yes, some people say my voice is similar to my mother, but I think it is not possible because everybody has the pitch of its own voice. So I think it's wrong phenomena that we have the similar voice of any other person.
Okay, let's talk about messages. How often do you send text messages?
I think it's time consuming to write a text message, so I usually prefer to send voice messages because it is easy.
Okay. Who do you usually send messages to?
Usually I send message to my husband because throughout the day we both are on our workplaces and we have no time for each other. Face-to-face talking, so usually we send message each other for any reason.
In what situations should we call instead of texting?
Should we call in actually when we are in hurry and we have no time, so and sometimes there is some emergency condition in which we prefer to call, and we not think that we should make text or a voice message.
All right, let's talk about holidays. Do you like holidays?
Yes, I am a working lady, so I like holidays very much. because holidays are the way of relaxation and they give us a thrill and they give us a glimpse to do something more better in the future.
Okay. Do you prefer one long holiday or several shorter holidays?
Actually, several shorter holidays are better than long holidays because when you have shorter holidays, then you make your small plans and you can easily act upon that. But when you have longer holidays, then you become lazy and you cannot perform your plans accurately. So I don't prefer long holidays.
Where do you like to go on holidays?
I usually like to go on holidays towards the northern areas of Pakistan, which are very beautiful and full of natural sceneries. So I also want to go there with my family.
What is better holiday destination, a city or countryside, and why?
I think it depends upon the situations and the weather conditions. If the weather conditions are very good and you think that you will be enjoy in the countryside, then we should go to towards the countryside. But if the weather conditions are very harsh and you think that weather is very crucial, so we should go towards the hilly areas or towards the city areas where we have facilities. So I think it depends upon the situations.
All right. Now in part two, I'll give you your cue card, 2 minute topic. You will have 1 minute to prepare on that topic and you have to speak for 1 to 2 minutes. Talk about an occasion when you helped someone in your family. Please say who you helped, how you helped him, her, how he, she felt at that time. You have 1 minute to prepare on that topic.
May I start?
Yes.
Ma'am, as my mother-in-law lives lonely at her home, we live at our home. So last week, she called me in emergency that she is not feeling well and better. And then I reached there at her home sudden, and then I find that she is not feeling well. She has pain, and she had pain, and she is feeling some problem in his breathing. At that moment I took him to the doctor. At my own car, and the doctor examined her with peace and calm, and then the doctor said to me that he has attack of pneumonia, and she suggested some medicine. After some time, we came back our home. I took him to my home, and she left me for a week, and I served him very well. And when she go back, went back to her home, she praised me and she gave me a lot of best wishes for my future and for my children. So I feel very happy when she praises me.
All right, now I will ask you a few questions related to this topic. Do you think helping people is important?
Yes, as we live in a society, and I think the meaning of the society is actually to help each other. And when we help each other, then we feel very comfortable and we feel peace and calm in ourselves.
Do you think it is necessary to teach children to help at home?
I agreed with you because when we teach our children to help others at our homes, then they keep it in their mind, and in future this advice help him to help others. So I think it is very necessary to teach our children.
What kind of tasks are suitable for teenagers at home?
Actually, first task is that we should learn them that they should become good persons and responsible citizen of their country. I think it is the foremost duty of parents.
What about household chores?
Household chores, they should must help their parents and especially their mothers in their household chores. In this way, we make them responsible and we create a sense of responsibility in them.
Okay, is it a good idea to punish children for not helping?
I think it is not good idea. Because when you punish someone, then you cannot learn him or her in the right way. So we should always try to teach them in very polite manner. In this way, they can understand better than in the punishing way.
Should parents force children to help?
I think we cannot. There is nothing can be doing by forcing. It is a self-creative thing. So we should produce creativity in our children, that they we should make them aware with their responsibilities and with their works.
All right. Do you think neighbors nowadays help each other?
I think this trend has become changed nowadays. We all have become very selfish. We are not helpful people as compared to past days.
Why?
Because we, I think there is the big phenomena of time in this matter. We have no time for each other, even for our family members. So we have very busy routines and we have no time for to help others.
Do you think it is important for neighbors to know each other?
Yes, I think when we talk about a society, then it is very, then it is compulsory to know each other. When you know each other, then you can easily knows the each other, not only the each other, but also you know the internal problem, and you can understand the problems of each other, and in this way you can help each other in well manners.
All right, this is the end of your speaking. Thank you.